I could show off my art and get paid for it.
Did I hear you correctly?
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm gonna take this and I'm gonna put this price tag on it. And okay. It's gonna go in the gallery with the rest of it.
Oh, okay. A gallery.
Yes, gallery. Okay. Gallery.
These are the surveys. This is the age range, which we found out that the ages of 13 through 18 mostly took our survey, and the second was 48 through 53. And this shows that the older generation can help support the younger generation with their artwork. Have you ever seen an artist that you think needs more recognition? We found out that people have seen up to one or two people who need more recognition with their art, and in total that everyone has seen way more than that. So this would be a good business for them. How much would you be willing to pay for somebody's piece of work? Most people said anywhere from $50 through $100. Nobody would be willing to pay more than $500. And this statistic can help us price our artwork at our business. This is the population sample. This is the spread of our survey. We got most of our responses from Ohio, and we got four from Pennsylvania, and this is the spread of the surrounding area of Hamilton.
For our market research, we looked into similar businesses, including Inside Out Studio and Art Space. Inside Out Studio is a place to people with developmental disabilities to market and sell their work and display it. And Art Space is pretty much the same as us, but their only complaint usually is that they do not have consistent hours, which we would definitely plan on having consistent hours so people know we're open and know when they can come in and all that kind of thing. And as far as Inside Out Studio goes, they're more for one specific group of people, and we are for everybody locally.
So basically, this is going to be our expenses for a month. Our total is going to be $32,484. Our biggest things are going to be the total wages and the total salaries.
And this is our income for the month of September. So as you can see, our expenses are a lot more than what we're bringing in. But over the course of the months that we are open, we are going to save the in total sales that we can. But we also are giving, as mentioned in the skit earlier, 40% of our income is going to that artist that sold the piece, and we are keeping 60% of that. So our total income will be around $21,894 for 1 month. And this is our revenue. The total will be $10,590. We are going to get most of this from selling our photos, paintings, drawings, and sculptures. Just a little bit of stickers and picture frames. And this is cute.
Yeah.
Thank you.
I have a question for you.
Okay, yes.
Thank you for your presentation. I think that it was really, really great. So knowing that area of Hamilton, knowing that that is kind of where Hamilton is growing and expanding, is, you know, that is a very neat location that they're currently building and everything. How did you choose that specific location versus a downtown Hamilton location?
Well, I feel like we chose that area, one, because we knew that it was newer, so people would want to go there to check it out. And like they were talking about is how the surrounding areas, like there's a lot of places people go to, so they would drive by and see our business and be like, oh, what's that? I want to check it out.
So I have a question that kind of follows up to that. Since you, because you won't get any foot traffic there, there'll all be drive-by traffic, what is your strategy to get people to be aware that you're there and get them in your gallery?
Marketing. All we really need is like a social media platform, something to spread the word, over the internet. The internet is such a powerful place where you can spread anything, and I think it can just be very helpful in that instance.
What would your message be? Why would they come to the gallery?
They would come because there's a lot of people that feel as though they don't get to pursue their dreams and they don't get to pursue what they want in life because they don't feel as though they can make a living off of what they enjoy doing. And they would come in to start that off. They can ground themselves and get themselves up and going with it.
I just to echo, you know, we see a lot of art galleries that locate next to restaurants because people have to eat every day. So it's like the foot traffic is really what drives it. It's not every day I'm like, oh, I need to go buy some art today. Mm-hmm. So you're going to try to rely on people who are bringing out walk-in traffic because they're going somewhere else. But I do think that the location will have additional tenants in it and hopefully have some type of restaurant anchor there to help pull people in. Do you know how many vendors that you were looking to have in your store?
Do not know the answer to that.
Okay.
Unlimited.
Yeah. Sorry, another question. The 60-40 split, did you research that at all? Is that the norm or?
We originally had it to where like we were gonna get less amount, I think like 20%, and like starting off a business getting only 20%, like that's not good. So we made it higher for us and for them to just so to start off, and hopefully we're hoping like by years and years later we can make it to where they get a little more money than us, but like we're still able to run the business with the money that we are getting.
Just opinion, I'm not sure that'll work. You know, artists value their pieces. So unless you are getting a price, so when you set your price, that's what I'm getting at. Unless you can command a price way above what you know what they can get on their own, you may want to take a look at that.
When you were looking at employees, were you factoring in artists working there, or were you hiring outside individuals to staff like this?
I know.
Yeah. I've definitely been involved with some who, if you're vending or if you're a vendor, that you're required to work a certain amount of hours, and that helps bring your expenses down because your expenses were pretty high for a small business.
Yeah.
The other thing that I would suggest is you may want to do some things to make this a destination point since you are on a drive-by location. You know, by doing receptions and stuff like that, you know, make it a place where people want. Because I think a lot of times people buy art at a time when they didn't intend to. Not that many people, I don't think, when you do the research, you know, get up in the morning and say, I'm going to buy a piece of art today. You know, but they see something, it speaks to them, and they purchase it. And that comes back to what Mallory was talking about with foot traffic and that type of thing.
Thanks for the impulse buy. Excellent job, team. We're going to go ahead and finish up with one last comment, and then we'll move to the next team. Kim Hart had a thought.
Yeah, I really enjoyed how you called our attention in the beginning with the presentation. It definitely set the tone. A lot of times, a lot of these art galleries seem to be a little high touch, maybe a little bit too, I don't want to use the word bougie, but I think that I think you guys are much more approachable than I've seen, especially for a business model, okay? Thank you.
Thank you.